Continuing with the comments from Judy Babbitts, excuse me. I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. My daughter is a critical care nurse at Mercy Hospital, presently working in the COVID unit. This was written by one of the doctors she works with in the unit. To all those who think the pandemic is over just because you're tired of it, or who think you are somehow magically immune, or who have a complete and utter disregard for the sanctity and worth of the lives you are so blatantly putting at risk. On behalf of the 1,077 American healthcare workers who have died treating COVID patients, and the other 18 million of us who are still out there risking our lives every single day, I would like to say this. What arrogance has so possessed you that you believe you have the right to endanger our lives by refusing to take basic, simple measures like wearing a mask and not holding large gatherings? On behalf of the 214,000 Americans who have died from COVID in the last 7 months alone, I would like to say this. What hubris holds so firm a grasp on your mind as to think you are different from those who have died? What blindness has so dimmed your sight as to believe that you couldn't possibly become 214,001? But most importantly, on behalf of the families with whom I have spent these 7 months hoping, praying, screaming, crying, and begging some deity to save their loved one, those families to whom answers will not come, will not find peace, and will likely never know why their family member died while others lived. Those families I have looked into the eyes and admitted utter defeat and complete helplessness to save their loved one from this virus. Those families who have had to watch their loved one languish as machines slowly take over the function of each organ system as they fail until they are entirely dependent on them to survive. Those who have been forced to make the decision to let their family member go without ever being able to see them in person, to hold their hand, to say, I love you one last time. Those who families members were, in all likelihood, infected by someone just like you who couldn't be bothered to take this situation seriously. On their behalf, I would like to say this. Who the hell do you think you are? Please consider all of the people who are risking their families every single day to keep our St. Louis County not just healthy, but alive. People don't want to wear their masks or follow protocols, but when they get sick, they want to be given the best care available. It's just not right. Thank you. Next comment from Jay and Pam Helwich. Dear Council, we'd like you to imagine a school shooting without students in this emergency. Imagine going in for a surgery without protocols for the surgery staff. Why would we face a pandemic without our county executive and county health department guiding us? Please vote no on 220, 222, and 223. Next comment from Bess Marshall. Dear County Council, I am so grateful to that St. Louis County has maintained mask orders and COVID precautions that have reduced the burden of the virus in the community. I am a pediatrician in endocrinology and diabetes and have seen in my own St. Louis County pediatric patients the devastating and so far permanently disabling effects of this virus. I also feel the fear each time I go to work that this will be the day I catch it from a patient or family member of a patient who decided not to be careful with their own health and so is putting me at risk. I have been issued one N95 mask to use for the duration of this. I guard it carefully as I know it stands between me and a chance of death or disease. I'm now faced with a COVID patient load from all around the state due to their lack of measures in St. Louis County. I am covering this weekend for one of my colleagues who was unfortunate enough to catch the virus himself. I struggle each day with the decision to carry on and continue to risk versus take early retirement or take my career to another country where more reasonable precautions are being taken. Please continue using health data, not politics, to make See, thanks. Next comment is from Sally Sandy. According to the Missouri Department of Health and Senior Services website, Missouri spends almost $3 billion annually to treat smoking-related illness. Missouri spends over $3 billion annually in smoking-attributed productivity losses. Given the burden that tobacco is to the state, when you layer onto it the unchecked burdens of COVID, you have staggering economic loss. Notice, I said unchecked. Thank goodness from the beginning, the St. Louis County Health Department has followed science to check COVID. All you have to do is look at other areas of the state that don't have mask mandates and health regulations to contain COVID, and you see stats like the 41% positivity rate in New Madrid County and the increase in cases, as in St. Charles County, that at over 8,800 have well overtaken mask mandates St. Louis City's 7,300. Even zip code 63025 in the Rockwood School District, even with the mask mandate, which doesn't seem to be that well adhered to, the zip code has, from the very beginning, been in the dark purple shaded area in the county map, denoting the highest rate of new cases per 100,000. In the beginning, this was put down to a nursing home. However, those days are long gone. Now the community owns it. As a retiree, I happily pay to support the Rockwood schools, just as those who currently have children in school do. However, I have not once been asked my opinion regarding education during COVID. I did call the district, got voicemail, and requested a callback. I got nothing. My personal opinion is that those of us who are at the most risk should at least have had a seat at the table in school discussions, just as parents did. However, since we are ignored in school decision-making, I have looked to Sam Page and the health department to rely on science to keep me and my husband safe. All I have to do is the county's positivity compared to the rest of the states for concrete evidence that their approach has been the correct one. For reasons stated above, I am against Bills 220, 222, and 223. Next comment is from Kathy Whitaker. To whom it may concern, I am writing to you in regards to those two bills that are going to be voted on. I have been a resident of St. Louis County for the past 26 years. I have never been so disappointed in the county government. I believe these bills need to be passed because one person should not be able to tell the citizens what to do. I am not for the mask mandate and have been shopping on dining out in Jefferson and Franklin County since he placed the mandate. I feel making kids wear masks all day long is wrong in school, but you will allow students to play sports without one? Personally, cannot wear one due to a medical condition. If someone wants to wear a mask, that is their choice. I should not be made to wear a mask and not be able to breathe. Thank you. Next comment is from Patty Fisher. St. Louis County Council members, I am writing to express that I strongly disagree with Bills 220, 222, and 223 that allow the mask and public health mandates established by public health experts to be overridden. Masks are proven to be effective at reducing the risk of COVID transmission, and I would love to reduce COVID transmission in St. Louis County. Simply put, numbers are lower where masks are worn and public health mandates are implemented. In a medical crisis in our community, we must listen to medical experts. We must do our part for our community by wearing masks and abiding by health mandates. Please do your part by following public health recommendations and maintaining mask and public health mandates for the health of St. Louis County. Please vote no on 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Sharon Fichter. My name is Sharon Fichter, and I am a healthy 66-year-old nurse who has been diligently trying to stay safe during this pandemic. We do not need less restrictions. We need to continue restrictions in order to handle the growth. I have an 89-year-old mother who has been in an assisted living facility and has been kept safe because of the restrictions. Please continue the efforts and do not lessen the restrictions. Next comment is from Maria Bayless. I oppose limiting the authority of the St. Louis County Council, St. Louis Department of Public Health to mandate pandemic practices. Mask requirements, social distancing, and crowd limits are crucial to getting this pandemic under control and getting us back to as normal as possible. These requirements are saving lives and are based on scientific data and facts. It's even more important as we head into fall and flu season. It also helps protect our most vulnerable and susceptible populations from this disease. Please don't let opinion and peer pressure define and dictate our approach. Do what is needed to keep us healthy and safe. The sooner we do all get on board, the sooner it will hopefully get better. Thanks. Next comment is from Julia Mendelo. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223. I urge the council to continue with to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. I am a 62-year-old woman with asthma and an autoimmune disorder, lupus, that would be medically impacted if common sense mandates like requiring masks are not required during this COVID pandemic. I don't want my health politicized. I also don't want my friends and family members who have health conditions to be compromised either. When people don't wear masks and socially distance, they put all our lives at risk for getting COVID-19. My husband is a surgeon, and when our community members don't wear masks, they put his health at risk and potentially risk his ability to take care of patients that rely on him for life-saving procedures. Moreover, if we want our schools and businesses to stay open, we need to provide safe environments. I want to be able to continue shopping in stores and markets and eating outdoors in restaurants. Masks and socially distancing policies have been proven helpful to mitigate risks. Please take politics out of healthcare for me, my family, my husband's patients, and friends. Thank you. Next comment is from Susan Weintraub. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree in the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with masks had slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. The recent story on CBS Sunday Morning highlighted how well China is doing in combating this terrible disease. People there wear masks for the health and safety of themselves and others. They don't complain, and they don't claim that it is the right of the individual. They go along with the mandate. They understand the vital role that masks play in controlling COVID-19. If people are not wearing masks in the places locally where I shop, I will not continue to go to them, and that will hurt those businesses, especially the local small businesses. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Amy Manley. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Things in our county are not getting better. I am an ICU nurse that deals with COVID-19 patients on a regular basis. These patients are sick, very, very sick. It doesn't matter if you are old, young, male, female, white, or black. It is affecting all people. By lifting a mask mandate, we are hurting ourselves, putting our healthcare providers at higher risk, and risking running out of resources. Science proves masks are a must to return to any type of normalcy. If there is no mask mandate, restaurants will fail. Groceries will have massive outbreaks. You will put more innocent lives in danger. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is easy and saves lives. It is a must and can slow the spread of COVID-19. I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Patty Scherzinger. I am writing in opposition to Council Bills 220, 222, and 223. I do not believe that the Council should be granted the power to change mandates enforcing the public to wear masks, social distance, or limit occupancy in public establishments, or limits on social gatherings for the purpose of the protection of public health from the coronavirus or the like. It is validated over and over that masks and social distancing have proven to be effective measures to limit the spread of the virus. This is a public health issue to be guided by science, not political pressure. Vote no on these bills. Next comment is from Patty Cantor. First, publicly thank Ms. Rivers for all she has done to support her constituents and all the citizens of St. Louis County. Your clear, concise, forward-thinking decisions have been a beacon of light in the otherwise dim surroundings of the squad. Second, to Dictator Sam Page, this next statement is in capital letters. If I were there to say this to you, it would be punctuated with disdain. You were wrong about schools. Are you listening? You were wrong about schools. We've known that for weeks now in St. Louis County. Yesterday it was announced schools are not spreaders. After almost 6 months of missed educational opportunities, they have decided they were wrong. Sam, you that last spring, nobody blames you for following the advice of the time. But the first and second, it was clear that the private and parochial school children in their buildings were doing well, not just lower grades, all grades. So many county children, especially those at risk, lost another month or more of education while you insisted you were correct. Stop it. You weren't correct. Now the World Health Organization is warning against shutting down cities. There are more long-range health risks to shutting them down than the risk of COVID-19. Open the county. Get rid of your silly masks mandate. Nobody wears them properly anyway. We aren't wearing masks anyway. We do our shopping in St. Charles County. To Lisa Clance, you can't help yourself. First, you call us racist and privileged because we disagree with you and your friend Sam. Then last week, you went off the rails and disparaged our president, governor, and your conservative constituents. Is it possible during the meeting today you can make it the entire meeting without alienating more citizens? We don't care what you think anyway. I have lost track of the bills introduced by several council members concerning the ending of the dictatorship of the county executive. Please vote tonight. Please vote yes. Hopefully after November 3rd, this won't be such a problem anyway. Next comment is from Laura Ming. Dear county council members, I am writing to urge you to accept the $2 million election grant for the nonpartisan Board of Elections. The pandemic has created significant challenges to our election process. This grant will be used to support a fair and equitable process and ensure that all voters can cast their ballots. The grant can be used to for poll workers. More are needed based on anticipated voter turnout. It can be used to fund outreach to voters to explain the election process, which is more complicated this year with different mail-in and absentee processes and mailing costs for absentee ballots. It will support added equipment to process voters at election sites. Again, this grant will ensure that all St. Louis County voters have a safe, secure, and equitable way to vote. Please vote to accept this grant.
All right, continuing with public forum. From Maxine Clark. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the Council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses, especially those that operate indoors, in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. We are over 65, and if lifted, I allow my husband or I to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19. We are already in the habit of wearing masks, and if we stop it, it will be very hard to restart. I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Russell Groner, Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. I'm frankly shocked this is being considered in the midst of a pandemic. Those who oppose mask mandates, citing personal freedom, fail to explain why they should have the freedom to pass on, unwittingly, if they have no symptoms, a deadly disease to others. Masks are our lifeline until an effective vaccine is available. They may even be more effective than the first vaccines. If this passes, I and my family will order everything we need online and will no longer support local businesses. Our health is too important to risk for the sake of a shopping trip. Masking works to stop the spread of COVID-19. Please, please vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. From Jeffrey Soyentet. Dear St. Louis County Council members, as an immigrant who has experienced all kinds of challenges, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. My wife is a nurse, and we have three kids between the age of 13 and 4 years. In August, my wife, our oldest daughter, and I tested positive for COVID-19. The experience was tough, and I would not want even my worst enemy to go through. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with masks noted slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Thank you.
Okay, I'll start over with John Valenti. I'm writing to support Bills 220, 222, and 223. I am a father of three kids and a soccer coach to many. I coach my high school daughter's club team. These girls are all practicing for their high school sports as well as playing club soccer. There have been no COVID cases on my team, nor in their families. These girls want the opportunity to play the sports they love. Deliberately antagonize those that support these bills with insults and derogatory comments. They will try to lure us into a mudslinging contest and disrupt our efforts so that the underlining issue is no longer clear. They will try to force people into taking sides. They'll do all this and more to shade the real issues, which will never be discussed. I'm writing to support Bills 220, 222, and 223 so we have clear check and balance of power in our county government. This is not about fighting for or against mandating mask or youth sports. This is about my belief that the efforts of the St. Louis County Executive to take control over me and my kids' lives, or the belief that he somehow knows how I should manage my individual freedoms without the lack of legislative oversight, all this in the name of government, knows best. This lack of oversight in the county executive position goes back years,
and needs to be fixed. These bills are about the abuse of powers granted the county executive with no expiration date and no legislative oversight. The issues with the budget, county auditor, CARES, and police funding, and misuse of tax funds. We have given up many of our constitutional rights and continue to make sacrifices for our families, though we are still called names by those who want to control our individual freedoms. We are simply asking for real data, clear targets, and uniform guidelines. Lastly, we are asking that executive powers have legislative oversight so that there is true balance of power. For these reasons, I urge you to support Bills 220, 222, and 223. From Esther Smaller, please keep the mandate. It is important for our lives. I do not want to die from something that could have been prevented. And from Lauren Whalen, please keep the mask mandate in place. With kids returning to in-person public school and flu season coming, we need to keep doing this one easy thing to continue to protect our community. I am proud to live in a county with a mask mandate because it shows we care about our community members. And from Max Brown, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect St. Louis County residents. I strongly urge politicization of public health policies. When I see the sign at the grocery store that no one can enter without wearing a mask, I feel secure. We can protect ourselves and others by wearing a mask. I think that it is immature and selfish of some of this got cut off, and I cannot read. I'm going to have to go back to Mr. Brown. Pardon me for that. Moving on to Marilyn Abrams. Do not restrict the power of the county executive to keep our population safe from COVID. Our county executive is the most knowledgeable person in county government at this time. Let's use his education and knowledge as a tool to keep the population safe. And from Dean Howren, I am writing to encourage your support and action to pass Bills 222 and 223. The last several months have provided examples of the negative consequences of unchecked power. I implore you to take haste and resolve the current imbalance of power in the county government before the new county executive's office. I'm thrilled to hear that families will have the option to return to school later this month. It's clear to me that this young segment of our community has suffered tremendously since last spring. Early decisions to close schools were justified because there simply was not enough data to make educated decisions. However, I believe the county executive failed our children when he did not revise those decisions with the data acquired through the spring and summer. Not just COVID data, but data related to behavioral and mental health. I cannot fathom how anyone conducting an honest and holistic risk benefit assessment for our youth could come to the conclusion that the risks of attending school outweigh the benefits. I look forward to listening to tonight's meeting. I hope all council members have received the information needed to properly assess the election grant introduced at the last meeting. I'm especially interested in hearing Councilwoman Day's opinion of the grant and the need for the grant given her experience with county elections. I don't claim to have knowledge of the process, but I would suspect the increased amount of absentee voting would spread out the work volume to make the election more manageable than in past years and lessen the impact of reduced polling place volunteers. Thank you for your attention and service. And from Sam Lewis, I am the varsity cheer coach at Ursuline Academy. We have a very competitive squad, and I consider our team the hardest working teams on campus, and we are very good. They work their butts off and are physically and mentally extremely strong, but these over-the-top restrictions are breaking them. We finally are allowed to chant at practices, but are still not allowed to stunt. This is giving us tremendous disadvantage. This restriction makes no sense. How can wrestlers and football players be allowed to tackle a stranger, but a cheerleader cannot stunt with her own peer? We compete in the St. Louis Regionals and Missouri State Championships through the MCCA, Missouri Cheerleading Coaches Association. We are currently the only squad from St. Louis County that compete at this high level. Therefore, every other single squad in the league, this is about 200, are allowed to stunt and practice to their full potential and have been able to since July. We also compete locally and nationally through NCA. Several of these competitions have been switched to a virtual format, but with these current restrictions, we cannot even compete in the majority of the divisions. Last year, we were second in the state of Missouri and sixth in the nation. The current restrictions are heartbreaking and detrimental to these girls' futures. We are getting held back, and it isn't fair. What are the reasonings for not allowing us to stunt when everyone else outside of St. Louis County can? It just doesn't make any sense. My three seniors all want to cheer in college. If they are not able to practice to their full potential, there will be a slim chance in making a collegiate team. This is not fair to them. They are amazing athletes and deserve a spot on a collegiate team. These girls have already been negatively affected. We cannot rob them of their collegiate career as well. There are several other private schools that have used the St. Louis County sports restrictions and use them as a guide to come up with their own rules and regulations. I am all for staying safe and making smart decisions, but at what cost? This is truly hurting these girls in more ways than one. Our sport is stunting. It is the main part of competitive cheerleading. To not allow us to stunt is like taking the basketball net away from the basketball team or the ball away from the soccer or softball teams. It just doesn't work. We cannot be competitive without it. We pride ourselves on being a competitive cheer squad. Ursuline is the only all-girl private school in St. Louis to offer cheerleading at the competitive level. Please help me help our girls. They need this. And from Myrna Palavric, with the number of cases rising in Missouri and other states, it is crucial to wear masks and to wear them properly. That is what the experts are saying, and we should trust the experts. If our government can't and won't help protect us, we are doomed to fail. I was shocked to hear that this requires a vote every 15 days. Is that true? Things will not change in 15 days. With winter approaching, things will only get worse since people will spend the majority of their time indoors where the virus spreads with ease. Why not wait to take another look at next spring instead? That would be common sense. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. From Roberta Brown, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they blatantly attempt to politicize public health. When there is a public health emergency, I want all of us to take our advice from the public health professionals that use evidence-based protocols to stem the spread of disease. I don't appreciate politicians making simple public health measures that save lives into partisan weapons that divide our communities. Our local public health experts have saved the lives of so many in our community. If we lift the measures too soon, we run the very real risk of undoing all the good we've accomplished. Instead of lifting these measures, we should build upon them so that we can boost our economy. If we don't take care of the virus, first, the economy will suffer and we will have gained nothing. If we commit to evidence-based public health measures, i.e. wearing masks, testing, and contact tracing, we can defeat the virus and safely build the economy. Any other approach is folly. We will end up in a limbo that will hurt our economy and our citizens much more in the long run. Mask wearing is undeniably simple, as well as being very effective at containing the spread of COVID-19. I urge all of you to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you for your attention to this matter. From Jean Kennedy, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a horrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Just this morning, I learned that a colleague's father passed away from COVID after attending a funeral just a couple of weeks ago, at which many were maskless. How can we consider measures that will certainly take the lives of our loved ones and those of our friends, neighbors, and colleagues? How can we live with ourselves if we purposefully put our citizens at constant risk? Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. And from Courtney Knoll, Lisa Gubernick, and Rebecca Rubin Shalansky, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223. As they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. And the next one is from Laura Horwitz. I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223. These bills politicize public health and put the inconvenience of a few above the health and well-being of the many. Instead, I urge the council to continue to enforce measures guided by public health experts to protect St. Louis County residents. The science is clear that masks work to slow the spread of the virus. This is a simple step we can take to ensure the health and well-being of our region. My children, ages 6 and 9, are able to follow the mask mandate and happy to do so to protect the health of their grandmother and other elders. If parents and children can manage the massive inconvenience of lacking childcare and schooling for months on end, then the rest of our community owes it to us to mask up, follow social distance guidelines, and believe science even when it's inconvenient to do so. If these restrictions are lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19. And I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. and from Jamie Haysmeyer. I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will, in fact, hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Please follow the science, and so we can take care of each other and get back to normal sooner. Herd immunity is not a solution. It is an abdication of responsibility. Thank you.
Continuing with public forum, from Reverend Linda Gastreich. The health data related to the pandemic's impact in St. Louis County, as compared to other parts of the state, proves that the right decisions regarding public health orders have been made. Since the mask mandate went into effect, we have been able to control the spread of the virus in our region. Despite climbing numbers of COVID-19 cases in the county, our hospitals have not been overwhelmed. Schools are beginning to reopen, high school sports are returning, and restrictions on businesses are being lifted. The mask mandate and other public health orders have worked and will continue to reduce the spread of the virus if we keep them in place. Bills 220, 222, and 223 would prove to be disastrous to the well-being of our residents and the organized operation of our local government, including the St. Louis County Health Department. I beg the members of the County Council to reject these bills. Passage will prove to be a short-sighted measure that will lead to a greater spread of the virus and increased numbers of people who are hospitalized from ventilators. The death rate will climb. Please allow our county leadership to make decisions that will provide protection and not lead us down a path which will only delay our return to the rhythms of life that we all miss. Thank you. From Rabbi Lori Levine. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223 as they reflect a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with common sense measures backed up by science to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. These measures have had a positive impact on our community, and I believe that they have allowed us to reopen as much as we have. They make me feel safe going to work outside my home and supporting our local economy to a much greater extent than I did at the beginning of our lockdown. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. I believe that St. Louis County will be all the better for maintaining these measures now and not needing to implement new emergency measures again in 2 months when we see a significant spike in numbers related to COVID-19 spread, such as hospital admissions and deaths. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses. I suspect others will do the same. As a rabbi and a citizen, I am proud of the sacrifices my community and congregation have made for the general welfare. We are running online educational programs and not gathering in large crowds for worship or social programming for the good of our members and their loved ones. We created a virtual holiday experience for our holiest of holiest days of the year. Not because we wanted to or because we felt like it. It was because we refused to become a public health threat and we abide by the Jewish values of pikuach nefesh, preserving life at all costs. Without these safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is a very simple thing we can do right now to control the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Todd Erickson, Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Heck, the White House is now a ghost town and an epicenter of the epidemic because people couldn't be bothered to wear face masks. These restrictions that have been put in place are important and necessary to fight this disease. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Randy Schenberg, Dear St. Louis County Council members, please vote to reject the following bills, 220, 222, and 223. If you care about the residents of St. Louis County, including my family and friends, please give your vote careful thought. I've been proud of how well St. Louis County is doing, enforcing masks, and it works to stop the spread of COVID-19. It's a proven preventative measure. I feel more comfortable leaving my house and supporting local businesses as long as I know masks are required. If not, I'm more likely to stay home. Why make things more difficult for our local businesses? I work with seniors and continuously worry about their safety, but I know if they are able to get out and are protected when out, I have some comfort in their well-being. We elected you. Please represent us with smart decisions. Please vote no on 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Emily Schell. Good morning. I am contacting the council today in regards to a potential grant from the Center for Tech and Civic Life. I am urging the council to accept this much needed grant to help conduct our election during unprecedented global pandemic. As you know, our current governor encouraged people to stay home if they did not feel safe voting. These funds will help make our polling places safe and encourage people to participate in democracy and help control the direction of our country and their lives. Funds from this particular organization have been offered throughout the country and have been readily accepted in nearby Missouri counties, St. Charles, Lincoln County. Any attempts to use scare tactics to prevent their use in St. Louis County are purely political theater. Please accept this grant and help secure democracy in Missouri. Thank you. From KJ Reynolds, members of the St. Louis County Council. I understand you are discussing and taking action on bills that, if passed, would require the council to affirmatively vote to extend any executive order issued during a pandemic beyond 15 days. I am writing in opposition to these actions, which put politics above public health. Your service to our country is appreciated, but health and safety shouldn't be up to a vote. It must be difficult to hear the angry voices of parents who want their kids playing sports, business owners concerned about their livelihoods, etc. But we are on the edge of a hotspot state, and more mandates now mean fewer deaths and a quicker return to sports and business. Please vote no and let the scientists and physicians continue to do what is best for public health. Thank you. Oh, and then he did add PS, and he shared a hyperlink for an NPR article. From Shana Thomas, Dear St. Louis County Council, as a concerned resident of St. Louis County, I am deeply concerned with the current bills, 220, 222, and 223, being proposed to override public health measures recommended by the County Health Department. I'm particularly concerned at what it could do to the mask mandate we have in place that has likely resulted in lower case numbers in the county. Public health professionals, scientists, and the medical community at large all agree. Mask wearing is the most beneficial tool we have at the moment to mitigate the spread of COVID-19. I would hate to see the simple yet important precaution removed from our toolbox. Please reject these dangerous bills that could take away a safety net for the most vulnerable among us. Thank you. From Patty Brasher. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I am writing to beg you to vote down the above referenced bills. Masking is the only defense we have against COVID-19 if we are to engage in the public arena. As we brace ourselves for the predicted second surge of the virus, along with influenza, we need to be more cautious, not less. My husband and I, both in the more vulnerable age categories, will not be willing to eat in restaurants, shop in stores, or even visit our physicians if you lift mask restrictions. We have worn masks every time we step out our front door since May, and will continue so until there is a vaccine. It's not an inconvenience, and it's proven to save lives. Further, increasing occupancy limits as we are forced indoors is flat out counterproductive. More people crammed will only promote spread of the virus. Do the right thing and extend masking requirements indefinitely. When this horrible pandemic is finally over, all citizens will remember which leaders protected them and which ones capitulated to monetary pressure. Vote no, thank you. From Brittany Clifton. Dear council members, I understand that many parents are upset their kids can't play sports at school. I understand people are ready to get back to what our normal used to be. I understand that wearing a mask feels inconvenient at times. What I also understand is that over 200,000 Americans, teachers, friends, relatives have died from this horrible virus. I, like so many others, have personally been affected by the virus. I've had family members contract the virus. I've experienced the stress of having to quarantine due to someone you were in close contact with finding out they had the virus. My family has been taking this very seriously, and we have been fortunate to not have contracted this virus yet. However, flu season is already upon us. Our numbers have been falling in areas with mask mandates, and less people have gotten the flu in those same areas. Masks work. We should not vote to end public health and safety orders, Bills 220, 222, and 223. This pandemic has exhausted all of us mentally, emotionally, and physically. By lifting these orders, we are inviting more danger into our neighborhood. I urge you to do the right thing. I personally do not want to see another spike in deaths. Thank you for your time. From Stephanie Whitney Jake Goncar. Dear St. Louis County Council members, please accept this letter as my strong request that the council reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. I work in the mental health sector and have witnessed the terrible impact of COVID-19. Many people are anxious to leave their homes, enter businesses, etc., due to people who do not follow safety precautions. The mask mandates make a significant difference in creating an environment in which we can all feel safe to resume some of our normal activities. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will, in fact, hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Deborah Freeman Clevens. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Just last week, the numbers in the area nearly doubled. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses and schools in an uncomfortable position. I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses and schools will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Additionally, I believe schools that will already have a shortage will not be able to remain open. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you.
Continuing with the comments. Comment from Dale Shooter, Laura Dantis, and Adam Skelkowski. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Betty Miller. I trust Dr. Page. Let the scientist doctor make his calls. I support mask wearing. How selfish to think one doesn't have to wear one. We are about to see another surge. Let's get through this so life can return to normal. Follow the experts' advice. Next comment is from Deborah Galula. To the St. Louis County Council, I would like to address the council on the subject of rejecting Bills 220, 222, and 223. I feel this rejection will put even more residents in harm's way. Missouri is already one of the worst states in this country with elevated cases of the virus. The county executive and the county health department should maintain their power. We need health authorities telling us what to do during pandemic times, not people who do not want to wear masks. Not wearing masks is also going to increase the number of flu cases, which will begin in the next months to come. More COVID cases means our economy will never return to normal times. Why would you want to make life worse rather than better for the people of St. Louis County? I strongly urge you to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you for your attention to this matter. Next comment is from Carol Moakley. Please leave mask mandates and occupancy limits in place. Relax requirements when so many cases are being reported each day. This makes no sense. Follow the science and help the community. Thank you. Next comment is from Tracy Stamper. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223. As they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. This pandemic is ravaging the country and is currently hitting our area especially hard. At this point, masks and social distancing are all we have. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Marlene Hammerman. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the Council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the Council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. I am the past president of the National Council of Jewish Women in St. Louis, and NCJW runs the resale shop at 295 North Lindbergh. We are able to keep our nonprofit business open because our staff and customers feel safe. If the mask mandate is lifted, I feel we are putting our staff and customers in danger. Our revenue stays in the community, funding our many community service projects and programs. If our customers don't feel safe, or our employees get sick and we need to shut down, those who need our help most will be impacted the most. As a resident of St. Louis County and a senior citizen, I am able to shop in our stores safely, thereby adding revenue to county businesses. If you lift the mask, I will no longer feel safe to go anywhere. I'm so proud of St. Louis County being proactive with a mask mandate, and that is why I think we have been able to keep our rates low. I will be utterly embarrassed if this mandate is lifted. I think St. Louis County residents believe in science and are intelligent. This is not forever, and we should be able to comply with a simple mandate that keeps all of us safe. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Kelly Hood. I am a Rockwood parent. I know there is a group of Rockwood parents whose voices have been heard loudly the past several weeks. They want their kids back in school without restrictions. Now they want this council to have to vote to extend executive orders issued during a pandemic every 15 days. These orders are vitally important. They should stand until the health department says they are no longer needed. There are so many Rockwood parents in favor of masks, occupancy limits, and other measures designated to protect public health. This pandemic is serious. Lives are on the line. Please know that the Rockwood voices you have heard lately are not a true representation of the district as a whole. Please vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Next comment is from Judy Kaplan. Hello, council members. I believe in science. I believe the only weapons we have to fight COVID-19 right now are masks. If you, too, believe in science, you will vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Businesses must continue to require their employees and customers to wear masks as well as social distance. Individuals must do the same. Do you believe in science, or does political pressure force your hand? I hope it's science that motivates you. Thank you. Next comment is from Nancy Brown. Please, I'm begging for all of you to do all you can to support Dr. Page and his mask limits for business, etc. I am terrified of getting COVID-19 and did not leave my home for months. After the mask mandate went into effect, I felt safe enough to go out, with a mask, of course, to certain places that I knew were paying attention to safety. It is heartbreaking that so many officials in our country are not basing anything on safety, but on money and politics. So sad that this will not end well for our country. Please, please, please do not take away our guidelines that we have now. Numbers will escalate, and we don't want that. Thank you. Next comment is from Karen Smith. To the St. Louis County Council, the fact that 4 lawsuits have already been filed against government entities that have accepted election grant funds from Mark Zuckerberg's organization should tell you it's a thinly disguised illegal grant. If St. Louis County accepts this grant, another lawsuit will be filed. Every person who votes for this, if it is passed, will be included. If receiving money is so desperately needed due to COVID, why weren't the federal relief funds used, especially for the primary election? The numbers don't add up. What would be the reason to have money to not spend besides the claim that you are too busy to administer it? Vote against the grant and save taxpayers' money. Next comment is from Mary Schulman. Dear St. Louis Council members, I strongly urge the Council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the Council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. We need to act prudently and smartly to get our amazing county back to pre-pandemic. Please let these critical measures stay in place so we can accomplish our end once and for all. Masking is undeniably simple and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from James Tornator. My name is James Tornator, a South County resident, and I hope and pray that mask mandates, occupy limits, and reporting requirements for long-term care facilities and will not be repealed. We are doing so good right now. All three of these are really important and necessary for control of this pandemic. Yes, the economy suffers some, and people that demand their freedom to do whatever they want are getting frustrated, but relaxing these mandates will open the floodgates. Let's wait till after the holidays. Yes, winter will be tougher, but maybe a vaccine will be on the near horizon, and if not, ingenuity will get us all through the winter and beyond if necessary. Let's continue to be safe and resourceful. Thank you. Next comment is from Richard Levy. Please do not support Bills 220, 222, and 223 to cancel the mask wearing mandate. We must not let our guard down at a time when COVID cases are on the rise. Thank you.
Continuing with public forums, returning to Max Brown, I urge the Council to continue with measures to protect St. Louis County residents. I strongly urge the Council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a true politicization of public health policies. When I see the sign at the grocery store that no one can enter without wearing a mask, I feel secure. Remembering at the start of the pandemic, we didn't know what to do. Now we do. We can protect ourselves and others by wearing a mask. I think that it is immature and selfish of those who don't want to wear a mask. They are taking chances on both their lives and mine. I choose to protect myself and those I come into contact with. COVID cases are up and down. We don't know what the cooler weather will bring. As a senior citizen, I feel very vulnerable, and that mask wearing is so easy to do. Excuse me. I am not talking about a statewide policy, though I wish it would be considered. I am more concerned with St. Louis County at this time. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Why would we even consider taking it away? Masking is simple and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. From Judith S. Anderman, MSW, I am a St. Louis County resident for many decades. I am also a retired MSW who managed public psychiatric services. I closely follow the pandemic and the management thereof. I have the utmost confidence in our county executive and the health department. I believe they are a model for other counties. Therefore, I strongly urge the county council to support the actions of the county executive and the health department and to not curtail their authority. From Trish Gunby, I am writing this as a citizen and as a state representative of the 99th District. In my household, there are healthcare workers who are mindful that staying the course and using science as our guide means we will ultimately be healthier as a community. Continuing to support mask wearing, hand washing, and social distancing in the coming months will be critical. It may also help minimize the flu. I would advocate for a continuation of these efforts. In the calls and emails I receive from constituents in the 99th, I continually hear from people who are doing the right thing and working to minimize the spread of the virus. They realize these short-term policies will benefit us in the long term. Their reasoning and responses are matter of fact, and that they understand it's what we need to do for the future health of our region. Until a vaccine is available and administered to the majority of our citizens, I believe it's important we continue to hold fast to these protocols and not let the virus get the best of us. From Lisa Gubernick, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents, specifically to wear masks. Medical and public health experts agree that universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. That is an undeniable fact. Look at the super spreaders where people did not have on masks and then the virus spread among people. Lifting the mandate will place businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. From Linda Wiggin, I am safe in St. Louis County with the mask mandate when I go to stores where I buy groceries and other essential needs. I am safe when I go to public places where masks are required, but I am not safe when there is no mask mandate. I trust the many scientists and doctors who have told us that masks save lives and stop the spread of COVID-19. Without masks worn by everyone, as is required now, when I'm in stores and other public places, my life and others' lives are in danger of getting COVID-19 and or spreading it to their families, coworkers, and others. Lives are at stake here. Why are there county council members who want more people to die or be harmed by the deadly COVID disease? Why are there St. Louis County Council members who are ignoring the facts that mask mandates are responsible for the decline in COVID numbers? Do these council members who want to repeal the mask mandate not believe in science? Are they more concerned about their popularity and getting reelected than doing the right thing that ensures the safety and lives of those they are elected to protect? I will no longer be safe when I go out to stores and public places if there is no mask mandate. I will be required to stay indoors more so that I can be safe and not get COVID. Again, why are there county council members who want more people to die or be harmed by the deadly COVID disease? Please reject Bills 220, 222, and 223. From Susan Bivens. I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a dangerous politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Anti-maskers have been flooding the comment board arguing for these bills. Please vote them down because, one, anti-maskers are asking for the right to behave irresponsibly whenever they feel like it. How is that their right in a public health crisis? Number two, passing these bills would allow people to endanger others by not wearing masks. Supporting the right of irresponsibility is a death sentence for an as yet untold and undetermined number of fellow citizens. Number three, when we know this pandemic will last for months, if not years, to come, why would it be necessary to reaffirm or revisit public health and safety orders every 15 days? Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures support our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures for their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. From James Hirschfield, I urge you to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223 that would put public health at risk. All leading medical and public health experts agree that the use of masks is number one to prevent and slow down this terrible virus. The record is clear since the last pandemic of 1918 that taking this simple measure will save lives. It is simple and common sense to do and effective in stopping the spread that continues to affect so many of our fellow county citizens. Thank you for your consideration and action to keep masks on. One moment, please. From Mike Simon. As a realtor, measures like these present our area in a bad light and gives people another reason besides crime to not move to the St. Louis region. We are already suffering economically as a region due to image problems and cannot attract talent and companies to move in to our area. Backwards thinking measures like these are just another reason why companies like Centene have set up a second headquarters in Charlotte and are starting the process of transitioning their executives over there and will eventually move out of our region. Again, I urge you to vote against Bills 220, 222, and 223. Also, as a realtor, I am exposed to people I do not know through open houses, showing homes, etc. It is simple to wear a mask and proven effective in the fight against COVID-19. Without a mask mandate, I would likely contract the illness and spread it along to many others before showing symptoms, as well as to my son, who is on an immunosuppressant therapy and has a compromised immune system. If you pass these bills, I will remember you negatively at election time and will campaign against you appropriately. From Janie Weiss, or Weiss, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 22222 and 223. This is an urgent matter to protect citizens in our community, especially those like me and my family members who are vulnerable to this hideous virus that has ravaged our country. I am pleading with you, if you care at all about the welfare of those you represent. As a nurse, I am extremely concerned about the safety of healthcare workers like me who must put themselves on the front line. I live in St. Louis County. Thanks for your urgent attention to this matter. And from Rebecca and Andrew Doska. We are residents of Ladue, Missouri, and strongly oppose the removal of the current mask mandate, which is the only thing that has been helping to curb the spread of COVID here in the county. Wearing a mask is not that hard. If people could do it in the hot summer, fall, and winter will be a breeze. If masks are no longer mandated, we will stop shopping locally in fear of those without masks, making it more dangerous for my family. We will order groceries from Amazon, stop going out to eat, and stop going to local retail stores. This will crush the local economy, not help it. Please follow the science and keep the mask mandate until we have safely crushed this virus. From Jennifer, as we all know, every step in the election process in St. Louis County, from the high-level decisions made by the Board of Election Commissioners to the act of checking in voters by a team of poll workers, is done on a fully bipartisan basis. These teams have been working hard to manage the unique challenges of a high turnout presidential election during a pandemic, which has had unprecedented impact on the ways in which St. Louis County residents are choosing to vote, as well as on the availability of poll workers who tend to be in higher risk categories to staff polling places. Adding to these challenges are a substantial change in the law regarding absentee balloting and the creation of a new category of mail-in ballot, each with different rules and each requiring voter education and outreach, a process that has been complicated by ongoing issues with the St. Louis County website. Additional substantial timely funding from a nonprofit grant should be a welcome gift at this difficult time, especially when people all over St. Louis County are feeling the economic impact of COVID. Despite this, right-wing extremists are using scare tactics to attempt to prevent the county from accepting a $2 million nonprofit grant from the election board to use in serving the voters of St. Louis County, the same grant money that other election jurisdictions in Missouri, such as St. Charles and Lincoln counties, have gladly accepted. This is troubling on many levels, not the least of which is that this fringe group apparently wants to force the bipartisan Board of Election Commissioners to either forego important expenditures intended to make our elections safer, more secure, and more efficient, or spend our hard-earned tax dollars on these necessary expenses just to score cheap political points with their extremist base. Now is not the time to play those games. I urge the council to accept this grant via a unanimous bipartisan vote and in an expedited fashion so that our bipartisan Board of Elections can use these funds immediately.
Continuing with the public forum, from Jonathan Chiles. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223 as they unnecessarily politicize public health decisions. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. While these bills do not directly implicate the masking order, one cannot ignore the linkage. Checks and balances are important, but decisions related to public health should not be influenced by politics. These decisions should remain with experts in the field who have the ideal combination of medical knowledge, public health expertise, and the most complete information. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the government requiring safety precautions, By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19. And I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Katie Powderly, I wish to express my appreciation for the hard work of the county government in keeping its residents safe. I have been impressed that the people of the county have abided by mask mandates and I'm thrilled to see that the rate of transmission in the county has decreased. Knowing that shoppers will be wearing masks allows us to feel safe entering businesses in the county. We choose not to go to Jefferson County to shop at all. We know the coronavirus can be deadly. We don't know who will become gravely or deathly ill, and doctors are still seeking to understand how to even treat this disease. To buy more time, we must listen to scientists and do our part. This includes the wearing of masks, a most basic act to keep the most vulnerable safe. From Jennifer Hipton. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the Council to reject Bills 220, 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the Council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. I am a healthcare worker, and I have seen far too many ill patients in the hospital who are battling this horrible virus without their loved ones by their side. As healthcare workers, we wear our masks for our long 12-hour shifts to help protect others. And I believe it is a simple thing to do to help prevent the spread and control COVID-19. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you for your time.
Jeannie, sorry to interject. I wanted to, I know we've been going for a while today, and I wanted to offer the opportunity to check in with the rest of the council members. I'm interested in making a motion and would like to make a motion to recess at 6 p.m. and reconvene tomorrow afternoon at 3 p.m. Shortly after the Justice, Health, and Welfare Committee hearings.
I would second that motion.
Did I hear a second from Councilwoman Dunaway?
Yes.
Any discussion from the council on that?
Madam Chair.
Go ahead, Councilman Trakas.
Normally, I would be willing to agree to that. However, I have a Port Authority board meeting tomorrow beginning at 4. So okay. I won't be available. That usually runs a good solid 3 hours anyway. So that'll keep me tied up until 7.
Okay.
Just to let you know.
Okay. Yes, I understand it may not be possible to find a time where everyone can be available. You know, we have a priority to at least have a quorum.
Right.
And trying to get a sense from other folks. I know there were a few council members who weighed in on the poll that I sent, but I didn't hear from everybody, so. All right, well then, unless anyone has any other discussion, we'll go ahead and take a vote on that motion. So again, the motion is to recess at 6 p.m. and reconvene tomorrow at 3 p.m. Motion seconded by Councilwoman Dunaway. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Reluctantly, no, because I'll only be able to stay for an hour.
Okay. Roll call, please.
Councilmember Days? You're on mute.
Aye.
Thank you, ma'am. Councilmember Dunaway?
Aye.
Councilmember Fitch?
Aye.
Councilmember Gray?
Aye.
Councilmember Clancy?
Aye.
Councilmember Tracus?
No.
Councilmember Harder? Councilmember Harder with us?
I haven't seen
his name is up there, but oh, there he is. Councilmember Harder. Councilmember Harder, are you with us? No. Okay, I'll put him down as absent. So on the motion to continue to 6 o'clock, recess and reconvene at 3 p.m. tomorrow, there are 5 ayes, 1 no, and 1 absent.
Okay, the motion carries. So with that, we will continue, and then we will recess at 6 p.m. So you can proceed, Janie.
Thank you. Continuing with public forum. From Renee Spiegelglass. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. This is beyond sad that people do not realize we are in this together to get well. Instead, I urge the council to continue measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19.
Yes.
States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. And I think there should even be a fine if people do follow the mandate. And they need to make sure the mask is covering their nose. Let's use common sense. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Please do not pass this bill. Keep us safe. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Leah Cordiano Siemens, to the members of the St. Louis County Council. As a concerned resident of St. Louis County, I am deeply concerned with the current bills 220, 222, and 223 being proposed to override public health measures recommended by the County Health Department. I am particularly concerned at what it could do to the mask mandate we have in place that has likely resulted in lower case numbers in the county. Professionals, scientists, and the medical community at large all agree. Mask wearing is the most beneficial tool we have at the moment to mitigate the spread of COVID-19. I would hate to see the simple and important precaution removed from our toolbox. Please reject these dangerous bills that could take away a safety net for the most vulnerable among us. I have underlying conditions that are of no fault of my own. I also work with high school children in large numbers. I felt pretty safe and better about my chances of not catching COVID-19 due to the current health regulations. If these rules are lifted and loosened, I fear I would have to change jobs, if that's even possible right now. I'm also the only caregiver for my mother, who is now heading into her mid-70s and vulnerable. If we do not uphold our regulations, I also fear I would have to isolate from the general public and my job in order to be there for her. She's only been out 3 times since March. That is very difficult for someone that lives alone. Please consider the rights of all your citizens. Wearing a mask and distancing is the easiest thing we could do, and it's working. Thank you. From Susan Schender. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I will cease from doing any business, including all stores in the county, if you do not reject bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. From Diane Levine. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I am writing with extreme concern for the bills before the council, which would put my family and me at higher risk for COVID and other pandemic infections. The use of masks has been well studied and is the primary reason for our health thus far, as we are devoted to using the masks whenever we leave our dwelling. No one is permitted to come into our apartment building without a mask. I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223. They are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents, especially for those of us who are in the high-risk categories like my husband and myself, who are in our 70s. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Please do the right thing and protect us with the most well-documented and common sense measures by keeping them in place for those of us who are most vulnerable. Also, we have ongoing concern for our healthcare workers who are most impacted and threatened by this virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Leslie Peters, to the members of the St. Louis County Council. As a high-risk resident of St. Louis County, I am deeply concerned with the current bills 220, 222, and 223. Being proposed to override public health measures recommended by the County Health Department. I am particularly concerned at what it could do to the mask mandate we have in place that has likely resulted in lower case numbers in the county. Public health professionals, scientists, and the medical community at large all agree mask wearing is the most beneficial tool we have at the moment to mitigate the spread of COVID-19. I would hate to see the simple yet important precaution removed from our toolbox. Please reject these dangerous bills that could take away a safety net for the most vulnerable among us. Thank you. From Alex Davis. Why on earth would anyone think now is the appropriate time to not require mask use in public facilities? Cases aren't even declining. Businesses are in fact open with the most minor of inconvenience, wearing a mask. Nobody benefits from this. From Lori Mills. I'm writing this week as there is so much to be done in the county to fully recover from the damaging lockdowns. Page is bad for our economy, bad for our kids, and continues to keep the county significantly restricted. Studies have proven schools are not super spreaders. Even the WHO has stated lockdowns are not effective and should not be continued or used in the future. It's long past time to remove all occupancy restrictions, which are crushing our economy and closing businesses, but are also challenging reopening schools, especially for public high schools. We have moved beyond temporary inconveniences, to quote Clancy, to significant infringement on our freedoms. Courts all over our nation are overturning continued restrictions as unconstitutional. St. Louis County is wrong here. Time to turn the page. We can never let this happen again. One person, no matter what party is in power, should not have complete control. Any council member voting against bills 220, 222, and 223 is voting to make themselves irrelevant and voting to ensure the citizens they represent are not heard. It is hard to explain why checks and balances would be a partisan issue. The anger and frustration that many citizens feel has had what is likely an unintentional result for the county leadership. Your voters are awake. This lack of oversight is historical and has not been fixed. There are issues with the budget, CARES and police funding, and misuse of tax funds. Clancy and others on the council are pushing for acceptance of election grants from outside sources with known political agendas. Uneven, seemingly nonsensical restrictions continue for youth sports with no scientific support for evidence. There is no defined end game for COVID restrictions. The answer cannot be when I say so, as if the people of St. Louis County are children needing to be directed rather than adults capable of making the best decisions for their families. There are several council members as well as the county executive that are up for election in this cycle. I speak directly to you. Your citizens are watching very closely. The days of sleepy council meetings are likely over forever. The current restriction lifting is not enough, and the recent digging in and calling concerned citizens entitled and racist is not doing over well. The council serves the people. Passing 220, 222, and 223 will demonstrate you are, and it cuts off there, but it starts, it looks as though it's listening, but it cuts off. From Joshua Luthauser. Please vote yes. I've never paid much attention to local politics until recently. The actions by Sam Page have been in the face of what current science is showing. We're in a situation where a single person is making decisions in direct contradiction to what the experts are suggesting. While his motives may never be truly known, one thing is clear. No single person should have this much authority over the county. Please move to put in place checks and balances that will make certain the decisions made regarding health crises like these are no longer in the hands of a single man or woman by voting yes on bills 222 and 223. Thank you. From Shelley Powell. Lisa Clancy and a group of concerned educators have been misrepresenting the community and kids sports advocacy group. The group is representative of many school districts in the county, not just Rockwood. I'm in the Webster Grove School District, and the group has not been focused on anti-mask, regardless of the narrative Councilwoman Clancy and her group are publicizing. Personally, my family and I wear masks when it's appropriate. Support bills 220, 222, and 223. It's important to note the opposition isn't providing any alternatives to the bills, but is solely focused on defeating them. County Council should be run with appropriate council oversight. The decision-making should not rest exclusively with one person and should instead employ a system of checks and balances. It's not a dictatorship. Because of the abuse of power from our county executive, many issues have come to light about the council and how it conducts business. The emergency powers granted to the county executive don't have an expiration date, but they should. There are issues with the budget, the CARES Act funding, police funding, and use of tax funds. Where's the transparency? Where's the process of checks and balances? The inconsistent and nonsensical at times, sports mandates and various community mandates have come to light. There doesn't appear to be an end in sight for the mandates and guidelines meant to originally flatten the curve, which we've done. Now the World Health Organization has repositioned itself, saying it doesn't recommend shutdowns due to the detrimental effects they have on mental health and economies. We're seeing the data in our own state and county about businesses lost, children suffering from anxiety and depression, and the low attendance rates for children attending virtual school. The light has been shown on the workings of this council and true motives of the county executive and specific council members. Support bills 220, 222, and 223 for the appropriate oversight and checks and balances. From Kara Scher. Please do not approve of this dirty Lisa Clancy grant money. We all know it's from very dirty lefty organizations with numerous strings attached. Vote no on grant money. Please vote in favor of Bill 220, 222, and 223. We need oversight on the county executive.
Continuing with the council comments. Next one is from Susan Tran. Dear County Council members, I encourage all members to vote in support of Bills 220, 222, and 223, limiting the power of the county executive. If you are not in support of limiting one person's power over the lives of citizens of St. Louis County, then I would question your ability to make sound judgments. The whole premise behind American politics is to have a system of checks and balances. If you don't believe this should be in place, then you may want to think about what happens if or when Sam Page loses. You realize you are setting the stage for whomever the county executive is, so if a Republican is voted in, they would have the power to mandate whatever they want. It isn't a good situation, no matter what your political affliction. One person shouldn't have that much control. You would like only vote against these bills if Mr. Page has promised you something in return. I want to thank Councilwoman Days for being an example of what American politics should look like. You are a Democrat, but you do not let that define you. You have intelligence and bravery to do your own thinking. You are trying to do what's best for the people you represent. Ms. Clancy has shown bitterness with some of her statements on Twitter regarding those questioning Sam Page's mandates and health orders. She said we are a group of parents from Rockwood and are being led by the GOP. This just goes to show her lack of intelligence and her unwillingness to work with people having different opinions than hers. Many parents from all over St. Louis County, from both party lines, have issues with what Mr. Page has been doing to our children. Many don't have issues when the lockdown first went into effect. We didn't understand this virus and were told 14 days was needed to flatten the curve. We're on day 200-something. We have asked Mr. Page to share his data so we can have an understanding of why these mandates are needed for children that seem least affected by the virus. We're intelligent people wanting a better understanding. We live in the Show Me State. We are simply asking Mr. Page to show us the data being used to keep things locked down. Next comment is from Erica Frost. To the council, I am a resident of St. Louis County, 63132, and vehemently oppose the amendments to Bills 220, 222, and 223 that have been proposed. Requiring a vote with two-thirds majority on restrictions to protect the public in a pandemic puts the possibility that our county would be left to the whims of people who do not believe science or scientists. A mere lapse in a vote would render moot any public health measures instituted by the county executive. As a nurse and an educator, I must speak up and protest potential actions that will work against science and those who are protecting public health. If you feel that the county executive has too much executive power, then make the amendments worded in a way that supports public health. Just take a look at what has happened in counties and states that are not imposing restrictions for the greater good. We must listen to the Department of Public Health and follow scientific guidelines and recommendations. The American Nurses Association Code of Ethics states that nurses have a duty and an understanding that sacrificing personal autonomy for the greater good of society, particularly in times of public health crisis such as a pandemic, must happen at times. While extraordinary, we must all work together following the science as it emerges to protect and educate the public in this pandemic. I strongly oppose the changes to these bills. Next comment is from Carolyn Skowira. I am a St. Louis County resident in District 3, DePere, and I oppose the passage of Bills 220, 222, and 223 because, as an epidemiologist, I recognize the importance of wearing a mask to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Every respected public health official and infectious disease expert agreed that the easiest, most effective way to protect ourselves and our healthcare workers is to follow the CDC mask guidelines. I urge you to vote no and continue the current mask mandate in place so we can continue to let our children go back to school in person this fall and keep our county open. Thank you. Next comment is from Stephanie Sutton. I am a St. Louis County resident. I do not support the passage of Bills 220, 222, and 223. These partisan attacks on science health are absolutely ridiculous, and I deeply resent that I actually have to take time from work and caring for my family to acknowledge them. Restricting the ability of our county government to protect us all with public safety measures is an emergency. Makes absolutely no sense. Please stop listening to rabid anti-maskers. There is a reason that St. Louis County is faring better with spread and new case rates than rural Missouri. Do not pass bills 220, 222, and 223. And I apologize if I don't say your name right. The next comment is from Arkna Kalfi. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I am a board certified pediatrician in Ladue. I am also a county resident and member of the Ladue School District COVID-19 Task Force. I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. I have been taking care of families with COVID-19 since the pandemic began in March. I have been impressed with the ability of our region to keep rates lower than many of our neighboring states. I believe this is largely due to the diligence of county leadership in heeding the recommendations of local and national public health experts. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of masking, and universal masking has proven effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. As we continue to embark upon the process of getting our kids back into the classroom and back onto the fields and courts playing sports, it is crucial we do all we can as a community to maximize the safety and well-being of the children, the teachers, and support staff at the schools. Low local transmission rates are paramount if we want school reopening to be successful and for our kids to be back in the classroom and resuming daily activities. We must follow the advice of public health officials. Masking has proven to be an extremely effective way to prevent transmission of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you for your consideration. Next comment is from Doug Stockenberg. As a taxpayer and resident of St. Louis County, I strongly support bills 222 and 223 introduced by Councilmen Fitch and Harder, and urge the council to adopt them tonight. Unfortunately, these bills are necessary to provide a vital check and balance on County Executive Sam Page, who apparently believes that he has unfettered power over the citizens of St. Louis County due to this pandemic, and our fundamental rights be damned. One of the core principles upon which our great American Republic was founded is the concept that governments derive their just powers from the consent of the governed, and that the purpose of governments is to secure and protect the rights of citizens. Another core principle is that governments have divided power to prevent the corruption of power in one single person or body. However, since this plague descended upon us last winter, Sam Page has repeatedly ignored the will of the people of St. Louis County, as he apparently believes that he alone has the power to grant or withhold rights in his sole discretion. Page also apparently believes that he should not be held accountable to the people or this duly elected legislative body. My primary concerns are that Sam Page has held hostage my own children's fundamental right to a public education as guaranteed in Article 9, Section 1A of the Missouri Constitution, and he has also imposed completely nonsensical restrictions on youth sports and spectators, all to further his nefarious political agenda. While Sam Page has also abused his executive authority in many other ways, suffice it to say that he has indeed become a petty tyrant. However, tonight each member of the county council has the opportunity to represent the will of the people by enacting long overdue checks and balances on Page's power. Although our collective attention is currently focused on Sam Page, if you allow his reign of tyranny to continue unchecked, you can and will become the focus when your respective terms expire. Please do not miss this opportunity to restore necessary balance to the St. Louis County government. The voters are watching. Finally, a brief message for Lisa Clancy. Let me be crystal clear about something. I fully understand the impact of these bills, so please spare us all another sanctimonious lecture this week. You can save those for your doomed re-election campaign speeches. Next comment is from Jennifer Seiss-Gansner. Dear Dr. Page, Council Chair Clancy, and St. Louis County Council, I appreciate your consideration. I grew up in Fenton attending Eureka High School before Rockwood Summit existed. I am now a 46-year-old mother in Kirkwood, just moved from Oakville. My three elementary, middle, and high schoolers learn online while I work and handle a toddler. As a youth, I participated in multiple sports and school activities while balancing academic achievement, received a combined scholarship to play soccer and double major at Lindenwood, got my master's at CU Denver, and attribute that high level of busyness to staying on a good path. I have multiple sclerosis and was raised by a nurse with an innate respect for medicine. I take seriously any threat to my compromised immune system. I desire real data, not just numbers, percentages, or buzzwords, but qualified analysis to actually correlate specific activities with COVID-19 transmission rates. With precautions, we continue to live pragmatically in a different world. Many parents like me are part of a 13,000-plus member Facebook group from all over the county. With precautions, we believe the return to many activities is working per the data. Neighboring counties are having more success than setbacks. Local private schools have been successfully in person for some time as well. Data has not been shown with a statistically significant correlation that youth school activities are primary contributors to the transmission of COVID-19. In a recent Kirkwood family survey, the lack of connection with peers and inability to stay focused were the worst data points. And I'm happy to report our school district is heading back, and I am highly impressed with their efforts in getting back into living, learning, and playing as safely as possible for our families. I am someone who believes in caution, but also in living during these times. We wear our masks, don't go out unnecessarily, and social distance when we do. I am not someone who is interested in party politics, agendas, egos, or fear-mongering. Bills 220, 222, and 223 should pass right now as a show of faith that our system upholds the proper checks and balances of our elected representation, whose voices we should hear as a reflection of our own. It's not too late to do the right thing. Vote yes on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Colleen Hogan. I'm a resident of Maplewood, and I'm writing to express my opposition to the passage of Bills 220, 222, and 223. We are still in the middle of a pandemic, and I am disturbed that these bills would mean the life-saving mask mandates we are currently protected by would expire 15 days after passage. Many times during the pandemic, I have watched how the virus has ravaged other communities that ignore science, and I have been comforted by the fact that I live in St. Louis County, where we listen to public health officials and mandate the evidence-based health measures of masking and crowd size restrictions. No one thinks these public health measures are fun, and we all wish the pandemic would end so we could gather freely. But wishes don't keep us safe, and we need to continue these mandates even though we are tired. My brother works at a grocery store and lives with my at-risk parents. It makes me sad that the council would consider removing the public health measures that protect him at work, putting him and my parents in harm's way. I, along with so many other St. Louis County families, are relying on you to keep our families safe. Please vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Next comment is from Rich Cohen. To the St. Louis County Council members and Interim County Executive, please vote in support of Bills 222 and 223. These two bills will only strengthen our county. They will put balance back into our system. The council was not formed to give sole power to the executive. I have watched several county council meetings in the last month. I have watched each of you vote on many different issues. If you don't think you should be able to vote on decisions made by the county executive, then I beg you to examine your reasoning. It doesn't seem that most things are voted along party lines, except, of course, the decision in April to give Sam Page power over the $173 million from the federal government for coronavirus relief. That was right down party lines with a vote of 4 Democrats to 3 Republicans. How will you feel, Lisa Clancy, Kelly Dunaway, Rita Days, and Rochelle Walton-Ray, when our county executive is a Republican? Would you still want him or her to have the same powers you have given to Sam Page? Next comment is from Rebecca Flack. To the members of the St. Louis County Council, as a resident of St. Louis County, I am deeply concerned with the current bills, 220, 222, and 223, being proposed to negate public health measures recommended by the County Health Department and health professionals across the nation. Mask mandates have proven their necessity and impact on lowering COVID caseloads in communities across the country, including in our own, and I am very worried about any measure that seeks to ignore the advice of the medical and scientific community, particularly as our students go back to school. It's only the most entitled among us who continue to ignore those who've committed their careers to the study of diseases and their transmission. I ask that you reject these misguided and misinformed bills that will only serve to increase spread and put so many at risk unnecessarily. You've been put in a position to help safeguard our community. Do not neglect your commitment now when lives are literally on the line. Thank you. Next comment is from Dr. Holly Hofgen. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I am writing to you today as a citizen of St. Louis County, a mother, and a practicing physician. As cases of COVID-19 continue to rise in the state of Missouri, positivity rate of 14%, we are doing generally well here in St. Louis City County, positivity rate of 4.4%. This is in large part to adherence to public health standards, such as mask mandates and social distancing efforts. I strongly urge the Council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they at the very least give the appearance of politicizing public health. Instead, I urge the Council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. I understand the frustrations that people are feeling. I have 3 young children who are attending school in my living room. They have been disappointed by loss of vacations, sports, and activities. However, medical and public health experts agree that universal masking and social distancing are effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19, and states with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. The fact that we have had these mandates in place are the reason we are now able to open our schools safely. Continuation of mask mandates is also how you open businesses safely. This allows us to continue to support our community businesses and protect ourselves and others at the same time. Masking is simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19. It is supported by all major medical societies and health systems. There is increasing data every day on its importance in combating this virus. It is a small thing we can do to help each other. Please put public health and safety in politics. Please help us help you. Thank you. Next comment is from Megan Hagen. Dear council members, I am writing to ask first and foremost that you lift all mandates and restrictions. There is not an emergency in St. Louis County or in Missouri for that matter. Our hospitals were never overrun and are not in danger of being overrun. No matter if restrictions are lifted, everyone still has the ability to make their own decisions. If they want to keep their children out of school, wear a mask, socially distance, keep their business closed, etc., they can still do so, but those of us that choose to carefully and thoughtfully move on with our lives should be allowed to do so. Next, I would ask that you vote yes on Bills 222 and 223, introduced by Harder and Fitch, removing the unlimited power of Sam Page. He has shown that he is unable to represent the populace based on science and facts and is purely driven by power and its own personal agenda. As for the $30,000 DPH grant to increase vaccine competence, skip it. Instead, focus your efforts on compiling real facts. Give the people accurate statistics, number of cases, number of fatalities, how many individuals that die of COVID have pre-existing conditions versus the safety profile of the new vaccine and the liability of the company that made said vaccine, and let people make their own decisions. You should not be trying to boost competence in anything. You should be giving people information and allowing them to make an educated decision, period. Lastly, return to in-person meetings. Why? Are you all still not holding in-person meetings? And please don't say it's because you need plexiglass installed or something ridiculous like that when my local Aldi can have plexiglass installed in a matter of days. It seems to me some of you are doing your best to hide from us and make it as difficult as possible for any of us to be heard. You can't even read all the comments, even though you have made it increasingly difficult to submit comments. We are watching and we will remember who acted in our best interest and the best interest of democracy and who was beholden to their own agenda, the agenda of corporate sponsors and big business. Thank you. Next comment is from Kim Linhares. To the members of the St. Louis County Council, my family and I reside in Kirkwood. As an early childhood educator, parent, and member of the community, I am deeply concerned with the current bills 220, 222, and 223 being proposed to override public health measures recommended by the County Health Department. As a teacher, I'm very concerned that a small group of families has demanded legislation that would impact the safety of all county residents. As a mother of a high school student who works in a grocery store, anything that weakens the public safety measures previously put in place will put my child at risk. This is unacceptable. I am particularly concerned at what it could do to the mask mandate we have in place that has likely resulted in lower case numbers in the county. Public health professionals, scientists, and the medical community at large all agree. Mask wearing is the easiest and most beneficial tool we have at the moment to mitigate the spread of COVID-19. I would hate to see this simple yet important precaution removed from our toolbox. I implore you to reject these dangerous bills that could take away a safety net for the most vulnerable among us. Thank you. Next comment is from Alan Bogar. To City Council, I respectfully ask that you support Bills 222 and 223. This is about reasonable oversight. It actually doesn't have anything to do with whether I believe Sam Page has done a good job handling this pandemic or not. I am crystal clear in my understanding of the impact of these bills. No single person or entity should have sole authority or decisions with such far-reaching impact, and it has nothing to do with political parties. If Sam Page were a Republican, I would think the Democrats on the council would feel that this is a reasonable request. Please vote yes for both of these bills. Dr. Page, I urge you to support these bills as well. It is a necessary check and balance that is important again, regardless of political parties. By approving these bills, you and the council have a wonderful opportunity to improve the way our county government is run going forward. Please urge our council members to support these bills, and please sign them when they get to your desk. It's also time to continue to ease your restrictions. I'm sure you've heard that the WHO does not advocate lockdowns as the primary means of control of this virus. Dr. Nabarro said, "The only time we believe a lockdown is justified is to buy you time to reorganize, regroup, rebalance your resources, protect your health workers who are exhausted, but by and large, we'd rather not do it." While we are not completely locked down, the current capacity restrictions are still causing irreparable harm. Please lift all capacity mandates immediately. Next comment is from Robert Holden. To the members of the St. Louis County Council, I live in Fenton with my family. Our business is also located in Fenton. I am extremely concerned that the council will be hearing bills this evening that will override county health department recommendations. I am most concerned about what effect these bills may have on the current mask mandate and crowd size ordinances that we have in place. As a business owner, we have been greatly affected by the pandemic, but I would not in any way want you to jeopardize public health by limiting health department recommendations by making them expire in 15 days if no action is taken on them. The quickest way for us to get back to normal is to wear our masks when in public, socially when possible, and avoid large crowds. Mask mandates during pandemics are good things for the general public. Masks are the best way to control the spread of COVID-19, and I am frankly surprised and saddened that people are so reluctant to do something so simple that benefits the community.
Continuing with public forum comments from Jennifer Herndon. In 30 years of voting, I have never cast my ballot for a Republican candidate. My views have always aligned more closely with what Democratic candidates have had to say, so I became one who blindly voted blue. When I learned this fall that my kids wouldn't be allowed to go to school or even to play sports, I began to look into who was making these decisions that were clearly not in the best interest of my kids. Over the past weeks, I have watched all the county council meetings and many of Page's media briefings. What I have seen from some Democrats leaves me with a heavy heart and an angry heart. My anger comes from the complete misrepresentation being pushed out upon the unsuspecting public as to bills 222 and 223 that are coming up for vote tonight. Do you want a politician or public health care experts leading us during a health crisis? They rhetorically assert while urging people not to support these bills. But this is a complete fabrication of the effect of these bills. What we have right now is a politician having the unlimited and unchecked power to make all the decisions during this health crisis. And he is not following public health official recommendations. For example, the St. Louis Sports Medicine COVID-19 Task Force, made up of 11 medical professionals representing the three major healthcare organizations in St. Louis, recommended in July to pull youth sports back a phase because of the number of overall COVID cases in the area. To further his agenda and messaging, Page reported that youth sports were the driver of the rise in COVID cases, an assertion that task force members Jason Newland and Mark Halstead specifically disagreed with, as quoted in the Post-Dispatch. Mark Halstead has also acknowledged that their recommendations to move youth sports into Phase 3 were not adopted by Page until long after they were made, and that Page's dictates continue to be out of alignment with the task force recommendations. Passage of Bills 222 and 223 does not take the decisions out of the hands of health experts and put them into the hands of politicians. They take such decision out of the hands of one man and put them into the hands of our elected council members. This way, each resident of St. Louis County can be represented. from Ann Dillon, Elaine Tucker, and Dana Sandweiss. I strongly urge the Council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223 as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the Council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. Lifting public safety measures will, in fact, hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. And from Emily Sarvies. Please pass Bills 220, 222, and 223. No one person should have authority for an indefinite amount of time anywhere in the United States. The Council should have oversight on what the county executive is doing. This will provide a way for the community's best interest to be at the heart of these decisions. Please vote against the County Board of Elections accepting money from the Center for Tech and Civic Life. As you know, several counties who have taken this money have been sued. St. Louis County does not need to be a part of that. Besides, during your last meeting, wasn't it determined that there was no clear understanding of what St. Louis County would do with the money or why we needed it? The fact that this was almost rushed through as a scare tactic is disheartening. Again, how about the community's best interest? The WHO is encouraging opening back up. They have issued emergency press releases encouraging the U.S. to stop shutting things down. Please understand the detrimental effects these restrictions have on our community. Our hospitals have not been overrun. We understand the groups of people who are at highest risk, almost the only risk. We need to live our lives in a way that allows for these people to protect themselves, but does not put the general population at higher risk of depression and suicide, in a way that allows our economy to thrive, getting people back to work and able to support themselves and their families again. Sam Page and Lisa Clancy have overstepped since April, and I've had enough. In addition, I'm well aware that Lisa Clancy has organized a group of people to write into you to help her oppose these viewpoints. She has even instructed them on how to ensure the email system will send the email right at 12:01 a.m. so that her emails spit into your meeting. I'm curious, is Lisa working for her constituents or are they working for her? And from Courtney Haig, I do not believe that the County Council should have the right to overrule public health experts in regards to the coronavirus epidemic. Please keep in mind the health and safety of our community. Why would you take away the authority of our County Health Department during a global pandemic? It is literally their job to protect our health and is staffed with people who have studied epidemiology and public health. There is no logical reason for people who do not have those credentials or who are not consulting with those same people to be making decisions that affect public health. From Nancy Rorden, many of us are overjoyed to see the return to most sports and a beginning to get these kids back to school. Businesses are up to 50% capacity. COVID is down in our county. These are good things. However, power corrupts. Absolute power corrupts. Absolutely. The temporary two-week lockdown was understood as we all needed to help. We gave up our freedom for the greater good voluntarily. However, there comes a point where officials do not have the right to make laws and restrict a healthy population. Sam Page may believe that he is doing everything for our own good, but our own good is not the same for everyone after a while. Some are more at risk from the virus, some are more at risk from the shutdown. Both risks are valid. There comes a point where constitutional rights must be restored and power must go back to normal channels. The council made a mistake of granting those powers to Sam Page without an expiration date. Now he does not want to give them back. Bills 222 and 223 must be approved. Sam Page should not continue to have unilateral decision-making ability for 1 million people. We are demanding a voice and representation. I believe in social distancing and masking. If it can save one person, it is worth it. But somehow masking and social distancing became stay at home indefinitely, and that was never the agreement. The foundation of our government is checks and balances. The legislative group makes law, the executive implements it. Judicial weighs in to interpret, except in St. Louis County, where Sam Page can make mandates and implement them indefinitely. Citizens should not have to fight you for our constitutional rights. Lisa Clancy called our group entitled. I say she is right. We are entitled to our rights as guaranteed by the Constitution. We are entitled to representation and life-changing decisions. It is crazy that we have to resort to the courts to get any kind of relief on the mandates. However, she also called us Rockwood parents who don't want to wear a mask. We have members in every district in the county. We have members in Webster, Kirkwood, Afton, Glendale, Hazelwood, Berkeley, Oakville, Melville, Parkway, St. Louis City, Fox, Northwest, Lindbergh, and on. And we will gladly wear a mask while we take our rights back. From Joan Grillion. Please vote against Bills 220, 222, and 223 that a small group of parents and council members are pushing in order to cut the power of the county executive and ignore the advice of the Department of Health by passing these bills. Please consider voting against Bills 220, 222, and 223 and keep our Department of Health nonpartisan and able to give clear and specific medical information to guide our elected officials. COVID-19 has already killed thousands of Missourians, even though the majority of St. Louis Countyans are wearing masks and social distancing. Hospital CEOs are clear in stating that the surges they are seeing come from counties without health orders. These surges could easily happen in St. Louis County should the passing of Bills 220, 222, and 223 come to play. It's proven that wearing a mask lowers the rate of virus transmission. My husband and I are retired and in the group of elderly who are mostly affected by this virus. We have been following the recommendations of the Department of Health by always wearing a mask around others, have not visited friends or relatives except at a distance. It is crucial these bills do not pass so we can return to normal life and once again hug our children and grandchildren. Please vote against Bills 220, 222, and 223. From Lori Watson. In regards to limiting the county executive's power, I am astonished this was not already the case. In any position of power, there are checks and balances. I have not heard one reason that supports unlimited power in government. It's frightening that some council members do not feel this is a necessary limitation, regardless of whether we agree with the decisions of the county executive. Next, in regards to the sports guidelines, we as parents make decisions regarding our children's safety and should have the freedom to decide if it is safe for them to play. I understand the concern for contracting COVID and spreading this to others, but COVID can be contracted in many places. I can go to the store among strangers, but I have to jump through hoops to go see my kids play hockey. These guidelines are nonsensical and place a huge burden on parents, volunteers, and sports administrators. We are wearing our masks and distancing. Now let us be able to move about freely and enjoy our schools, sports, and entertainment. From Christine Benson. In Nicole Galloway's audit report dated August 12, 2020, the inadequate oversight of the county council was highlighted. How could this finding of inadequate oversight lead the council to believe that giving the county executive complete and unchecked control the right thing to do. The State Auditor's Office would seem to encourage oversight, and it is your responsibility as the council to represent the voice of your constituents and require this oversight as well. It seems funny that the root of what brought down Stenger was lack of oversight, and the same pattern is now repeating. The decision to let the county executive have complete control of the CARES money was initially described as required so that decisions could be made quickly. This has proven to be 100% false. Since speed in distributing the money is no longer the reason for the county executive to have complete control of the money, what is the reason? Small businesses and schools needed that money months ago. That money was needed by healthcare this summer when the line for COVID testing was hours long and the wait time for test results was 10 plus days. The delay in distributing the money has been damaging to our county, your constituents, and is suspicious. Is the county executive holding on to the money until after the election so he can distribute it to those who donated to him? Is he waiting to repay favors? This is what one is led to believe when there is no transparency or oversight. Is the county executive really going to veto a bill that gives oversight to his decisions? This is bold. Anyone who has nothing to hide would welcome oversight. As a county council, it is your responsibility and duty to provide oversight and represent your constituents. One person, without any oversight, making decisions, is not the way the county council was designed to work. If you vote against oversight, you vote against the idea of a county council, and the council itself becomes unnecessary and obsolete. From Beth Nelson. I am writing to encourage you to vote for bills 220, 222, and 223. The hope is that the power of the current county executive or the next county executive will be limited, so there will be necessary oversight of the county executive by you, the county council. These issues have been divisive with lots of name calling, and I just don't understand why county executive oversight by the county council is a bad thing. Please help get these bills passed and then get to work immediately on garnering the necessary votes to override what will likely be a veto by the county executive. Again, does anyone else find it ridiculous that the man whose power we are trying to limit has the ability to veto the bills that will limit his power? Thank you for your diligence and consideration. And from Heather Lampert, I am a Chesterfield resident. Please do not lift the county mask mandate. This county mandate is our only hope in keeping our kids in school. Please vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you for making the right choice for our children and keeping the St. Louis County mask mandate. From John Marisak. Members of the County Council, I implore you to pass bills 222 and 223. They give you the voice the county executive page doesn't want you to have. Your constituents depend on you to be their voice on the council. If you vote no, you are telling them their opinion is of little consequence and you are unwilling to fight for them. If you vote no on bills 222 and 223, I have to ask, what is your purpose? Dr. Page, when these bills pass, you have said you will veto them. Why are you so against giving your county council members a voice? Your actions suggest you don't want to listen to anyone, including your county council. It's a shame you are more interested in ruling as a council of one than operating in the manner government is intended. Council Chairwoman Nick Clancy, I don't offend easy, but your tantrums in the past 2 weeks have done it. You should be embarrassed with the way you have used this platform to incorrectly characterize those of us who are fighting against your restrictions. I feel terrible for the people you claim to represent. We are not a group of racists with the sole goal of ending the mask mandate. We come from different places, different backgrounds, different races, and have different opinions on many things, including which restrictions we feel need to be lifted. I think it's time to lift all restrictions, let people choose their path instead of you, County Executive Page, and those elect to stay silent. I don't think you understand the damage your restrictions have on your community. For example, your ban on tournaments. You can't stop youth sports teams from participating in tournaments. You just send them elsewhere, costing your area hundreds of thousands of dollars. Thousands of hotels once filled with teams sit empty. Restaurants who thrive during tournaments forced to close. Either you have no idea what you are doing to these businesses or you don't care. If you vote no on Bills 222 and 223, we will know the answer. You still have time to do the right thing. Lift all of your restrictions on youth sports. Lift all restrictions in St. Louis County. Support your businesses and give the rights back to the people. From Karen Wessels. I would like to encourage each of you to strongly consider voting yes on Bills 222 and 223. A yes vote will in no way hurt the residents of St. Louis County, but instead protect residents by ensuring that each council member has a voice in what is best for those constituents they represent. Checks and balances are always appropriate in maintaining the credibility of any organization, and especially in the county council. I would like to take a moment to thank those members who show up each and every week. Listen, ask questions, and truly serve your constituents. I very much appreciate your service. Please vote yes for Bills 222 and 223 to ensure the integrity of the County Council. From Gail Arroll. I support Bills 220, 222, and 223 to limit the County Executive's power. Lisa Clancy tweeted that the issue is about experts making the decisions versus politicians. That's not accurate. It's a decision about whether we want one politician, Sam Page, making the decisions versus multiple politicians, our county council making the decisions. Our county council representatives were elected to represent the residents of St. Louis County, and without it, we are not being heard. I want my county government to support the youth in the community. Support them by helping to find ways to get them back in school and back to their activities. Instead, the message has been virtual school is best, and entire schools have been forced to quarantine. Virtual learning has not been a success. It takes more than a hotspot to get a quality education. Our county executive wanted to cancel the entire fall sports season rather than try and work with the community to figure how to help kids get back to what helps them to be healthy and happy. The damage being done to our children is immense and will last much longer than the COVID crisis. I want my county government to support business. The continued restrictions on businesses are not sustainable, and many, many more will be forced to close their doors if the restrictions are not eased. And now I'm hearing that you want to raise my property taxes to make up for lost revenue. I do not want my taxes raised. We need businesses to be successful so they can generate tax revenues to fund important services to the disadvantaged and elderly. I want my county government to recognize that we have made progress in the fight against COVID. We have found successful treatments and the death rate has decreased dramatically. The restrictions should reflect this progress. We need reasonable mitigations that allow people to assess their personal risk and make a choice. You have put too much power in one politician's hand to make decisions that affect our lives with no expiration date on that power. It's time to fix it. Vote yes on 220, 222, and 223. And Ms. Clancy, I am not a Donald Trump supporter or a member of the GOP. I've voted straight ticket Democrat until now. Furthermore, I wear my mask and am in favor of the mask mandate for now. And from Michelle DeSalvo, I would first like to say that I am a resident of St. Louis County, and I have the right as a citizen of this county to voice my concerns to this council. I am not a child that needs to be lectured by Lisa Clancy about why Bills 220, 222, and 223 are bad for our county. Lisa, you threw a temper tantrum, and boy, did you look ridiculous. Your little tirade last week was an embarrassment to you. You look childish. Please start acting like a grown-up. I think since you lectured me last week, it's my turn to lecture you because you behave like a child. I wonder and hope others start to wonder why you and some of your colleagues on the council don't want checks and balances for this county. You and Paige are hiding something. This is not normal to have no checks and balances, and now you want to take shady money from the Center for Tech and Civic Life, calling it a grant. when we know they help with ballot harvesting. Ballot harvesting is where organized workers or volunteers collect absentee ballots from voters and drop them off at a polling place or election office where anything can happen to those ballots while driving them to that polling place or election office, and any one candidate can make ballots disappear if they are not in his favor. Did you learn nothing when Steve Stenger went to jail? There were no checks and balances by the council, and we see how that turned out. Regarding bills 220, 222, and 223, it must be a yes vote. Instead of the power being in the county executive's hands alone, there would be legislative approval by our elected representatives. I am not sure how this is a bad thing. Lisa Clancy's tantrum of why it would be bad to approve these bills sounds like she is trying to hide something for Sam Page. There is definitely something fishy about her covering up for Page.
Continuing with public forum, from Rhiannon K. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Lifting public safety measures will hurt our local economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures for their patrons. Masks are the best chance we have, in tandem with occupancy limits and other protective measures, of providing a safer environment for essential workers, immunocompromised people, and the general population. My husband will not feel safe shopping at stores in St. Louis County and will find somewhere else to shop, probably in Illinois, and I imagine other families will have to make similar decisions. Masks allow us to visit outside with at-risk family and with friends. I am on a leave of absence from my job as an architect to be with our son for his virtual kindergarten. After my husband and I have spent months both working from home and taking care of our son, I'd hope to return to work in January at the end of the first semester, if the virus caseload was consistently low enough for school to be in session. If the mask mandate is lifted, I imagine that schools might not reopen or that those already open will be able to continue to operate in person without more cases of COVID among teachers, staff, and students, forcing more parents, especially mothers, into the precarious situation of working and overseeing children's education or having to leave their jobs. I'm urging you to please vote no on 220, 222, and 223. From Jessica Little. Hello, council members. I'm an occupational therapist working directly with elementary students at a public school in St. Louis County. As a result, this gives me a unique position to look at what is going on with students in the county from both a healthcare provider perspective as well as an educator perspective. My school is currently operating under a hybrid model to provide partial in-person attendance while still limiting the number of students in the building to allow for social distancing, which has been recommended over and over again by the top health organizations as an effective way to curb the spread of COVID-19. In addition, all staff and students are required to wear face coverings, which is another simple and effective measure aimed at protecting the staff and students, particularly those with health conditions that put them especially at risk during this pandemic. I've been very thankful for Dr. Page's ability as the county executive to respond to the needs of our community to put measures in place like mandatory face coverings and limitations on crowd sizes that protect and especially the most vulnerable of our community. Therefore, I want to share that I do not support bills 220, 222, and 223. And I hope that the council will vote no on these bills. Each of these bills would significantly roll back the measures put in place to allow the county executive to make evidence-based decisions to protect our community, which means that life-saving executive and public health orders could expire in 2 weeks without additional intervention by the council. Given our current circumstances in this pandemic, maintaining the ability to enact measures that save lives and protect vulnerable people isn't simply a way to love our neighbors. It's also just common sense. So please, speaking as someone deeply invested in the educational system and in the health and wellness of students in St. Louis County, as well as the many passionate, dedicated staff who are working harder than ever this year to meet our students' needs, I'm asking you to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223 in order to protect lives and the health of our community. Thank you for your time. From Ashley Jamison. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I reside in Baldwin. I am married with four boys. My three older children attend Parkway Schools. My oldest child has special needs. He is almost 13. After 7 months, he will be returning to school in a couple of weeks. We are lucky that his education team has worked so hard with the virtual format, but everyone would agree in person is best for his specific needs. He only gets so many more years of public education. As his mother, I am extremely worried. Worried that if COVID-19 restrictions and safety mandates are lifted, we could face another lockdown. My son's education is so much more than academics. It is teaching him important life skills. He is given crucial therapies by dedicated educators who deserve a safe environment to teach. His father and I cannot replace these amazing people. So I strongly urge the council to reject Bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County. Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on Bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. From Donna Brodsky. Council members, the coronavirus pandemic places many challenges on St. Louis County residents and institutions, not the least of which is the responsibility of the Board of Election Commissioners to conduct a safe, efficient, peaceful election on November 3rd and in its aftermath. The Board of Election Commissioners' challenges are compounded by the flood of absentee and mail-in ballots already being received by post offices throughout the county. Moreover, an unprecedented level of participation by registered voters is, as you well know, anticipated. Every available resource at the council's disposal must be brought to bear to assist the Board of Election Commissioners in its duties related to the November 3rd election, from cleaning and staffing the polls to counting all ballots in a timely and accurate manner. It is therefore imperative that the council accept the available $2 million and grant funds to support the Board of Election Commissioners in fulfilling its responsibilities to county residents relevant to the November 3rd election. To do otherwise would be the most serious and inexcusable dereliction of duty on the part of the council. From Lori Richmeyer. Dr. Page, Council Chair Clancy, and St. Louis County Council. The WHO is urging leaders to stop using lockdowns as a primary control measure. It's not necessary at this point. The curve has been flattened. Enough is enough. Council members, you have the authority to stop this by voting for Bills 222 and 223 being presented by Councilman Fitch and Harder. I urge you all to think long and hard about the lives you are affecting. Adults and children have become anxious, depressed, and suicidal. Businesses are going bankrupt and closing doors permanently. These lockdowns were never meant to be permanent. We will not be silenced, and our voices will be heard loud and clear on November 3rd. Please vote yes on 222 and 223 and stop this overreach of power. Lori Carter. St. Louis County Council. I have been a resident of St. Louis County for over 20 years. I reside in District 6. I currently have one child who attends Melville High School. I am not a Rockwood School District parent. My daughter does not play football, but she needs to be back in the classroom full time, as do all of the children who attend schools in this county. I'm asking that you vote yes on Bills 222 and 223 introduced by Council Members Fitch and Harder. This is not a mask issue. These bills are not dangerous. It can no longer be up to one individual to dictate what goes on in this county, whether Democrat or Republican. There has to be a system of checks and balances. There must be oversight of the St. Louis County Executive. I bet after November, when we have a new county executive, some of you will be happy there's oversight of the county executive. As to those members who think we have not been listening to council meetings, I have been listening and watching. I don't think some of you are listening, and that was apparent when certain individuals took their headphones off as soon as the public comments portion of the meeting started last week. Hard to believe that Sam showed up for this meeting, although I doubt he was really listening. How long are we going to keep our kids from getting the proper education they need and are entitled to? How long are we going to watch businesses in St. Louis County close? The World Health Organization has recently announced that they are urging world leaders to stop using lockdowns. The curve has been flattened. It's time to move forward. Please do what is right for this county and vote yes on bills 222 and 223. Thank you for listening. From Liz Deacon. Honorable council members, we are in the middle of a deadly pandemic. Missouri does not yet have the spread of this under control. Bills 220, 222, and 223 will mandate 15-day renewal periods for any emergency mandates. This is absolutely unsustainable. The only kind of legislation you should be passing right now would be to expand the powers of the council to protect and keep constituents safe. I strongly support mandatory mask mandates, and these bills are a step in the wrong direction. I know you are getting a lot of pushback against mask wearing and keeping kids out of schools, but the science is unequivocal. Mask wearing is the number one best protection against COVID-19, which to date has killed over 201,000 people. I am not ready to be in public with non-mask wearers. I am not ready to send my kids or my husband, a teacher, back in rooms full of people. Please do not let the noisy few families and individuals convince you the majority of households are dismissive of the seriousness of this pandemic. I urge you with the strongest request to oppose any legislation that would decry science in favor of public sentiment. That is unacceptable, and I urge you to consider the safety of your constituents as priority number one and use science and facts, not opinions, as your guide. From Scott Bell. Please vote no on bills 220, 222, 223, so as not to undo the mask mandate and restrictions on business so we can continue to work to get COVID-19 under control in the county. Do not give in to the vocal minority who are ignorant and do not believe in the science and CDC guidelines. From Joan Hoffman. Ladies and gentlemen, I strongly urge you to pass bills 222 and 223. If you choose not to reign in the power of Sam Page, you are against the Constitution of the United States. Either support checks and balances or you will be exposed as our enemy. Sam Page, you need to rescind the mask mandate. As a rape survivor, I cannot tolerate wearing a mask for any length of time. I urge you to think of women who suffer domestic abuse only to have their county executive require them to relive severe trauma. Imagine being suffocated and thinking death was imminent. Imagine having to beg for your life from a man in a ski mask like I did. The masks are against public safety, not for it. You know very well cloth masks are useless. Get rid of them or we will do it for you. Lisa Clancy and Kelly Dunaway, if you truly care about women's issues, stop letting Sam Page force us to relive our trauma with his mask mandate. Ms. Clancy, stop shaming people who can't wear a mask. Do not call me selfish and do not call me racist. Know that we do not appreciate your attempt to prevent our comments from being heard. Let go of your ego and listen. If you fail to read comments from those who don't agree with you, we will go public. We've had enough of your abuse. Sam Page, you need to debate Paul Barry III. Do you want to win or do you want to win with honor? If you think victory is a sure thing, think again. From John Tooley. Emergency orders related to public health should be made by those medical officials charged with maintaining public health. Sadly, politicians cannot be trusted to make public health decisions requiring scientific, medical, and statistical expertise. Countermanding public health orders can result in catastrophic effects on St. Louis County businesses by raising risk levels to unacceptable levels for the majority of county residents, forcing them to seek home delivery from out-of-state businesses rather than patronizing local businesses for their needs. Additionally, public health measures are critical to making employees feel an acceptable level of risk in order to continue working in local businesses. From Elaine Divis, there has been a lack of oversight in the county executive position that goes back years and was never fixed. Temporary powers granted by the county council with no expiration date paves the way for abuse and power and eliminates checks and balances. 1 million people in our county deserve checks and balances of the county exec, regardless of political party. Because of the lack of oversight, there has been an ongoing abuse of power, such as the following. Number one, acceptance of election grants from outside sources with known political agendas. This includes an attempt to rush the passage of the grant acceptance without detailing how that money would be utilized. There is no such thing as free money. What are the stipulations of acceptance? Number two, uneven application of sports mandates. Cheer cannot stunt. Tournaments cannot play. High school football players lost half their season for no valid reason while the entire state got to play. Number three, no clear measurable goals and objectives for St. Louis County COVID metrics. No end of restrictions in sight. When do things reopen and how? When I say so is not acceptable. One person or office cannot have this kind of power. Number four, unilateral mandates have destroyed our local economy and the education of our youth, especially of small businesses and those who are most needy. The WHO has come out and recommended against lockdown as a primary tool to fight COVID because of the destruction it causes. Number five, county metrics follow irrelevant age groups. It is October of the school year. Only 25% of high school seniors will be 18. Yet we are still including 19 in this group. County Council, we need your support. If you defeat these bills without any compromise, what are you hiding? Are you trying to hold on to the power to control instead of lead the people of St. Louis County? The people of St. Louis County deserve better. We live in a democracy and our government has been guided by a system of checks and balances. We need you to pass bills 220, 222, 223, so that Sam Page and any future county exec is accountable and has limits on power. Thank you. From James Grillion. Dear County Council members, COVID-19 is a global pandemic that has already killed thousands of Missourians, even though the majority of St. Louis Countyans are wearing masks and social distancing. Hospital CEOs are clear in stating that the surges they are seeing come from counties without health orders. These surges could easily happen in St. Louis County should the passing of Bills 200, 222, and 223 come to play. A small group of parents and council members are pushing to cut the power and ignore the advice of the county executive and the Department of Health by passing Bills 200, 222, and 223. Please consider voting against Bills 200, 222, and 223, and keep our Department of Health nonpartisan and able to give clear and specific medical information to guide our elected leaders. I am a 79-year-old Army veteran, retired, and in the group of elderly who are mostly affected by this virus. My wife and I have been following the recommendations of the Department of Health by always wearing a mask around others, have not visited friends or relatives except at a distance. It is crucial these bills do not pass so we can return to normal life and once again hug our children and grandchildren. Please vote against Bills 200, 222, and 223. From Orville Borger, if ordered by the health department, masks should be worn. My wife and I have underlying health concerns. We always wear our masks when we go to the grocery. It is not a hardship. Please concern the health of others. The wearing of a mask is not an inconvenience for us, and we are 72 years of age. It has been shown that masks are effective. We will never get rid of COVID as long as people don't wear masks. Ask the people of Jefferson and St. Charles counties. Finally, if a little 9-year-old boy in Nazi-occupied Warsaw during World War II can hide in a neighbor's attic for 2 years without ever coming down to see the light of day, and I am thoroughly disgusted with people who think wearing a mask is a hardship.
Madam Chair, if I may interrupt for a moment. Madam Chair. You're muted, Madam Chair. Well, all right. Can the rest of you hear me?
I'm sorry, fine. Councilman Trakas, one of our staff members was talking to me.
All right. As I explained earlier, Madam Chair, I have to leave the meeting at this point. I have another meeting at 6 that I need to get to, so I apologize for having to leave early. I appreciate the staff and all the effort they put forth today.
Yes, thank you. We will make sure to note for the record that you are leaving at this point, and we will see you when you are able to join us again.
I'll see you tomorrow at 1, right? Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman.
Not 1.
3 o'clock. We have Justice Health and Welfare at 1 tomorrow.
The record will reflect that,
very well. Okay.
Madam Chair.
Thank you, folks.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
Continuing, from Barb and Lance Tyson. Dear Dr. Page, Council Chair Clancy, and St. Louis City Council, this is our week 4 for us on letter writing to the council. I urge the council members to pass the bills limiting the power of our county executive past 15 days of an emergency order. If the government can suspend your rights anytime it deems something a crisis, you don't have rights, you have permissions. Give us our rights back. This is not about wearing a mask. This is about having checks and balances with our county government. We currently have no checks and balances with our county government, and all the power is given to the county executive. It is about parents having the ability to make choices as parents. It is about small businesses having the ability to make decisions about their business. We are not a group from Rockwood School District, far from it. We are a group comprised of like-minded individuals from all over St. Louis County with diverse backgrounds and diverse demographics. Council Chair Clancy's lecture to the council last week was again inappropriate and not factual to any of the issues that have been brought before you. Her rhetoric is divisive, childish, and disrespectful. She acts like a spoiled brat who is not getting her way and does no act as an elected official should act. Please pass bills 222 and 223. From Esther Cohen. Dear St. Louis County Council members, I am extremely concerned with this terrible idea of lifting the mask mandate in the County of St. Louis. I am pleading with the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223. And urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. The medical facts are right in front of our eyes. The only way to slow down the spread of COVID-19 is by implementing public masking. Lifting public safety measures will not only hurt our local economy, or will only hurt our local economy. I am a real estate agent, and I depend on these mandates to keep myself and my family safe. I cannot show a house to a buyer if they are not wearing a mask, and I cannot ask my sellers to allow buyers into a house if there is no mask requirement. And in turn, I cannot provide for my family if I cannot work. This is our livelihood. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Wearing a mask is the easiest and most effective way of containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you.
Continuing with council comments from Matthew Benson. Listen, lads, you serve us, the people, in case you have forgotten. Your mindset should be set in keeping us safe and protected, and a part of that is keeping the masks. It doesn't matter if it's uncomfortable, you can't breathe, or you get acne. Just grow up and wear the mask. If you say we're not required to wear a mask anymore, you will see more cases, which means another shutdown and a heavy lockdown. It doesn't matter if they don't like it. This is for their and yours, might I add, safety. So keep this in mind when you start seeing people getting sick. Kids are slowly going back to school, and we'd like to go back fully eventually. Masks save lives, and it can save yours. So I ask you to really consider your options. Do you risk the safety of thousands for a few days of freedom with no mask, or do you keep the mandatory mask and save the lives of thousands of hardworking Americans keeping us together during this time? The choice is yours, so choose wisely. Next comment is from Domonica Green. We shall continue to wear masks. It's really protecting us. The glass is protecting us as well. Thank you for your concern. Next comment is from Lori Goldman. Please keep the mask mandate. It can really save lives in our community. I have been in rural Missouri, and it is obvious no one wears masks when they aren't required. Thank you. Next comment is from Deborah Spiegel. Dear St. Louis County members, please reject bills 220, 222, and 223. They will cause concern to the public health and probably raise coronavirus cases even higher than they are. I wholly support Sam Page's policy of masks and social distancing. It is imperative to continue measures to protect all citizens, including the most vulnerable, to this horrible, very contagious disease. Why would you even consider going against medical, scientific, and CDC health guidelines? That does not seem prudent or safe or wise. This virus has kept me at home and almost germophobic. I'm first beginning to go to the grocery store, pick up dinners or ice cream, sit at a park, and golf. If masking mandates are removed and this simple but effective protection is no longer intact, then my family and I, along with many others, will cease these activities and more taking business away from local owners. This is not good. Businesses need the support of the mask mandate to be able to fully enforce mask wearing. This is for their protection as well as the public's. It's not fair to expose citizens and essential workers to unnecessary risks. Masking is simple and effective. Please vote no to all three bills. Next comment is from Elizabeth Cole. St. Louis County Council members, I strongly urge the council to reject bills 220, 222, and 223, as they are a terrible politicization of public health. Sorry about that. Instead, I urge the council to continue with measures to protect the health of St. Louis County residents. These have been crucial measures that have led my family of five to feel safer in public. Medical and public health experts agree on the importance of public masking. Universal masking is effective at curbing the spread of COVID-19. States with mask mandates have exhibited slower growth rates compared to those that did not. Universal masking policies have prevented thousands of COVID-19 cases. It's a shame Missouri was one of the few states without mask mandates, but I've been proud of St. Louis County and their leadership in mandating masks. Lifting public safety measures will in fact hurt our economy. By lifting the mandate, the county is placing businesses in an uncomfortable position, and I fear that without the government requiring safety precautions, businesses will not be able to enforce masking and other safety measures of their patrons. If lifted, I will not allow my family to continue to visit local businesses, and I suspect others will do the same. Without the safety measures, we are endangering the lives of our most vulnerable population and our essential workers by unnecessarily exposing them to the virus. Is it fair to force a waitress to make the decision between virus exposure and her job? Masking is undeniably simple, easy, and effective at containing the spread of COVID-19, and I strongly urge you all to vote no on bills 220, 222, and 223. Thank you. Next comment is from Ruth Bauer. I am a senior citizen living at Bethesda Gardens, an independent senior apartment complex. We have had to wear masks outside of our apartments and socially distanced from one another since March. I have not touched any of my family since that time, and it's been very stressful. However, we haven't had any cases of COVID-19, and if we continue observing these rules, I have faith that we will overcome this pandemic. Don't end public health and safety orders such as mask wearing and reject bills 220, 222, and 223. Mask wearing saves lives.
Next comment is Lynn.
Yes, ma'am.
You can stop there for today. It is 5:57. I did say we would recess at 6 p.m., and I wanted to leave the last 3 minutes so that we can make sure that we are squared away on the details for tomorrow. So we will recess at 6 p.m. and reconvene tomorrow, October 15th at 3 p.m. in the afternoon. We need to make sure that the public has the link to join us. I see that Chuck Henderson, our IT director, has put the information into the chat box. Thank you. This information has also been posted to the St. Louis County website. And then, Jen, can you remind me if there's something, do we need to roll call out?
No, ma'am. You just do you can just announce a recess or.
Okay. Yep. Well, consider this the official announcement that we are in recess again until 3 p.m. on October 15th, tomorrow afternoon. I want to thank and recognize and salute our staff. This is a lot of work for them, and we owe all of them a great deal of our gratitude and appreciation. So thank you.
You're welcome.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.